Merry Christmas, brothers and sisters. It's such a delight to have you join worship with the Community of Faith of First United to welcome Georgian Shores, Central Westside, Katy, North Derby and Kilsyth, and the wider world that celebrates the gift of God's love. Welcome to this time of worship as we come together, even though we're apart. We know that we're connected in a profound way. Come and worship. Friends, you have a devotional life, and often in your reading of Scripture, you probably have your favorites, where you turn again and again, or perhaps these words are even written on your heart. John's Gospel begins in a cosmic reach. He doesn't just pay attention to the personal and that relationship with the holy, but he pays attention to the connection of which there is no end or limit. And in John's words, the celebration of light. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. We give thanks, the Word made flesh, God's love incarnate, Emmanuel, God with us. There is light. The gift of God's love, made known in Jesus. Let there be light. Thanks be.
One small child, one tiny child. sleeping in a lowly manger. Oxen and sheep all gather round to warm the one small child. One bright star, one shining star, dancing in the winter heaven. Travelers search through the long cold night to find the one small child. Gloria in excelsis Deo, a song is in the air. Gloria in excelsis Deo, it echoes everywhere. One new life, one special life, bringing all the world together. Peace on earth that has come this night in the love of one small child. Gloria in excelsis Deo, the angels loudly sing. Gloria in excelsis Deo, the joyful news they bring. One great gift, one precious gift, filling all our lives with wonder. Share the joy which comes this night in the love of one small child. In the love of one small child.
Let there be hope. From Matthew, these words of invitation and encouragement. Come to me, all ye that are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. We respond with our living and we carry the light. And that is a sign of hope. Friends, there is hope. Friends, there is hope.
Thank you.
Let there be peace. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. We welcome the peace that passes understanding, the peace that we participate in, the peace that is a promise fulfilled. Friends, there is peace. Friends, there is peace. With thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Jesus Christ. Rejoice in the Lord always. Thanks be to God that there is joy. Faithful ones, there is joy.
Thank you. My name is Ann Tettenborn, your mission and service enthusiast here at First United. I remember many a time at Christmas when my brother and I were looking so forward to getting the Sears Wish Book, looking through the Christmas catalogs and giving our parents hints what we wanted to get for Christmas. And this is one of the best catalogs that you can possibly use, Gifts with Vision. And to date, we have reached 76% of our goal towards the Mission and Service Fund. And I have faith we can reach our goal again. And this year, please be a Christmas angel like the top of this beautiful tree and give to the Mission and Service Fund. Take care and God bless, and wishing you all the best. Merry Christmas and have a Happy New Year.
Let there be love. A reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 1 through 13. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am but a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not ever insist on its own way. It is not irritable nor resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices rather in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we now know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I spoke like a child. I reasoned like a child, and when I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, and then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now, these things, hope, love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. This is the word of the Lord.
Loved ones, there is love.
Thank you.
Friends, we haven't been able to be together, but we've been companions on a journey of faith for such a long time. And it's a time of offering and giving of ourselves. And I know as communities of faith, you give thanks for the worship, leadership, and spiritual care that Kara McCluskey offers to the community of Katy, North Derby, and Kilsyth. And at a special juncture, we're at blessing and sending forth Reverend Nicholas Forrester, who has served the community of Central Westside since 2017. And Gwen and Roy Nichol McDonald joined the Community of Faith of Georgian Shores United in 2012, and it's time for Roy to retire. So there's journeys that continue, and even though we're invited to pause and recognize how our cup overflows, we also say, fare thee well, God bless you on your journey. So we extend that blessing and sending forth to Nicholas and to the journey that Roy is embarking on. For each of our communities of faith, may we find ways in this extraordinary time to continue our journey that's collaborative and caring for the community of which we are a part and creation of which God loves. Thanks be to God for your offerings. Let there be life. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went to the town of Nazareth in Galilee, to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy to all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was there with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to all." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. Friends, there is life, abundant life. Thanks be to God. Friends, Advent for the Christian community is a time of preparation, of making ready, of seeking to recognize God's activity in the world. And you've been on a remarkable journey, a journey that's included silence and reflection, generosity and love in action. Christmas is a time of fulfillment. The promise is lived into. Through the gift of Jesus, there is hope. There is joy. There is peace. There is love. So as you journey, may you take time to pause. May you rest in the peace that passes understanding. May you rejoice in the abundance of good news. May you share the blessedness of love, and may you live with the defiant hope. Thanks be to God for the fulfillment of the promise, the longing, the deep desire, in the gift of love in Jesus. Friends, whatever table you're able to gather at through this extraordinary time, I pray that you might know the presence of God as you break bread. When we break bread and we share that cup of abundant life, we do it in remembrance. We do it in remembrance of Jesus. And today, as we've lifted up the story of hope, peace, joy, and love, we live like we mean it, that it's been fulfilled. And again, in our word and deed, we will seek justice, healing, that we might be a sign of hope and peace in the world, and that we might know that residing joy. May you have a blessed Christmas, and may you be a blessed Christmas. Amen.
It's called But For Now, a song I've written in the last 2 to 3 weeks. On a cold winter's night, so very long ago, a baby boy was born. On a night filled with wonder, a single star shone bright, while an angel choir sang glory all around. Tomorrow will bring trouble for this child and all the earth, but for this one moment we celebrate his birth. But for now, baby Jesus, gently close your eyes as your mother's love holds you close. Sleep while the star shines brightly overhead and the shepherds kneel before your manger bed. A baby no longer, the truth would soon be clear. Was God's living word, bringing light in the darkness, a way to live in love. He would show that way to those who chose to hear. But storm clouds still would gather while he lived with us on earth. But for this one moment we celebrate his birth. But for now, baby Jesus, gently close your eyes as your mother's love holds you close. Sleep as the star shines brightly overhead and the shepherds kneel before your manger bed. Our journey continues with adventures yet to come, with stories still untold. So we come to the manger on this holy night to be bathed in glory from the star so bright. And as we face tomorrow, we pray for peace on earth. But for this one moment, we celebrate his birth. But for now, baby Jesus, gently close your eyes as your mother's love holds you close. and the shepherd.